I'm ready to start growing my hair out. I decided to start doing protective styling because if I don't do protective styling, I'm always ready to either dye it or cut it. Like, I'm obsessed with cutting my hair. So it's growing really quick with the protective styles, but you get these Instagram bloggers and these girls doing the tutorials, like Avon with these amazing huge afros, and you just feel like, how much longer do I have to wait?
Well, I would say to you, Chris, that really the length of your hair is going to be based primarily on genetics. So, as long as you're living, your hair is going to grow. I like to teach people and say, if you're breathing, your hair is growing. And I think it's great that there's so many wonderful girls who have hair tutorials and they're able to show off their hair and be able to share tips on what they did, but it's not just a one-size-fits-all.
Yeah.
So I think with the experimentation of growing hair out and seeing how long it can grow, I'm definitely going to be by your side to make sure we're keeping it healthy.
Thank you.
That you're not tempted to bleach it.
Yeah. Which was the next temptation, because, you know, I spent all that time hanging out with Mo, and her hair was like the brightest blonde, and every day I was like, I'm gonna dye my hair blonde. And, you know, I never really got the courage to keep it that way and let it grow at the same time, because I'm afraid of the damage that it'll cause. But I like doing the henna, and I like, you know, experimenting with the different colors, with the braids. It's fun.
Yeah, the extension will allow you to play with color.
Yeah.
And as we did today, adding like the really light highlight, you can play with it without really damaging your hair, so we can see how much length you can get. Because length is really about retention. So the less you manipulate it, the longer your hair will grow.
Key! The less you manipulate it, the longer your hair will grow.
The less you manipulate it, the longer it will grow.
I like that.
You gotta leave it alone. Let it do its thing. You know? Let it be. Let it live. So in your new song, one of your lyrics is, check Instagram and all the Twitter postings and wonder what the world thinks of me.
Yes.
So when you wrote that, where did that come from? What were you feeling?
You know what? I was literally laying in my bed, waking up to the morning, and I went to go check my Instagram. I was on my, you know, getting ready to go film for R&B Divas, you know, one of the episodes. And I realized how, like, obsessed I began to become, to the point where part of my morning ritual, including my coffee, was to check my Instagram posts. And I wrote the song as honestly as I could. I wanted Super Chris to be honest. So when I wrote that, I was like, I'm really telling my fans, like, that they affect me. I don't know if they know, you know?
Right.
Part of the Super Chris song is the fact that I don't know if my fans realize that if they say something that hurts me, it actually hurts.
Right.
And if they say something nice, it's actually nice.
Right.
I respond just the way anybody else does.
Wow, I think that's powerful. I think we all can relate to that. Like, how many of us are guilty of waking up in the morning, rolling over, and checking social media?
It's almost
checking our comments. How many new likers do I have? How many new followers?
It's a little strange.
Yeah, it's a little strange.
But I mean, And you want to say, oh, it's a marketing tool, oh, it's to sell more, right? But no, everybody wants to be loved. Yeah. Everybody wants to be loved for what they do, for who they are, for who they believe that they're supposed to be. And Instagram and Twitter kind of give you a little bit of a barometer.
Yeah, I think that's such a great lyric. It's so relatable.
Thank you. Okay, so I have a question, and this is probably, when I have braids, I want to wash my hair and I want to condition my hair and I want to do the lock method. Is that a real method, for one? And two, how should you moisturize your hair when it's in a protective style? Is it okay to squeeze the oil bottle into your scalp every 2 nights?
Well, when you're in a protective, okay, first of all, the whole lock method.
Okay.
The lock method is nothing new.
Oh, it's a good thing.
It's a good thing, but I think it's just something in this world of, again, social media, people having access, that people gravitate towards sayings and things that make it easier for them to remember basic maintenance and hair care regimens that have been around for a long time. So all that to say, yes, lubrication, oil, and cream.
But the word cream is where I get lost.
Right.
Because there's all these jellies, gels, like I don't know what a cream is anymore.
Right. So I'm going to keep it very simple. Okay. I'm all about kids. Keeping it simple.
Smart.
Sexy. That first, you want to moisturize your hair. Water is the number one moisturizer.
Mm-hmm.
So I always tell my clients, water-based product.
Okay.
So hair milks.
Okay.
Water-based product. Well, actually, let's take a step back. Deep condition.
Right.
Like your hair, tightly
mm-hmm.
coiled,
mm-hmm.
deep condition.
Yeah.
Because you first want to infuse moisture into the strand
mm-hmm.
through the deep conditioning.
Right.
But then a water-based product adds even more moisture and other probably great ingredients like essential oils and things that they mix
yeah.
into water-based products. So I like to say hair milks because they're typically water-based products.
Okay.
And then lubrication, you think of oil.
Okay.
Oil-based products. To keep it simple, coconut oil. Great emollient, which means that its molecules are small enough to penetrate your hair strand,
mm-hmm.
yet it helps to seal in moisture without completely locking out additional moisture.
Okay.
And then when you're in a braided style, you really don't need any cream because all of that just gets built up in the braids and it creates an accumulation of dirt and product that can lead to like a flakiness and then an itchy scalp.
So what should I do on a daily basis?
So when you're in your braids,
mm-hmm.
I would just simply say, like for instance, this cornrow style we're doing,
mm-hmm.
I would simply say if you need to cleanse your scalp, then you can just use a clean towel
mm-hmm.
and you can use something like witch hazel,
okay.
which I always say if it's gentle enough to put on your face, you can put it on your scalp.
Okay.
But then you just lubricate it. Focus on oil-based products.
Okay.
So you can use like a coconut oil and a tea tree oil.
Okay.
On the scalp, and you can spray it in the hair and just
okay.
focus on keeping the strands lubricated, especially because like today we're using synthetic hair.
Mm-hmm.
And so you want to make sure that you're not just focusing on the scalp, but you're also focusing on the length of the twist, so where
okay.
your hair is, and just making sure you're keeping it lubricated because the synthetic hair can dehydrate your natural hair.
Oh, okay.
And then cause it to break once you're taking it out though.
Okay.
That's a misconception. A lot of people are like, synthetic hair breaks your hair. Like, no girl.
Oh, it breaks it if you are not gentle when you take it out.
A lot of women experience breakage during the takedown process.
Mm.
So I'm like, the hair didn't do it, girl, you did it.
Oh gosh, no.
So another lyric that you wrote is it okay that I write what I think for a living?
Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of times I spent like time trying to figure out what people want me to write about. So for instance, I wrote a song called Best of Me, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then I'd meet somebody and they would say, oh, that song got me through a divorce.
Mm.
And I was in court. So then I write a song called Blame It On Me, thinking about those people who told me that. Then I meet somebody else and they would say, that song got me through a lot, but I'm trying to be strong now. So then I'd write a song called Better. And I'd say, this song is to get those people through what it is that they're going through. You know, and I'm always thinking about the stories people stop and tell me
mm.
when I'm backstage or when I'm shopping or wherever I am. For Super Chris, I decided that I wanted to write what I think
mm.
and let that be the main voice of the EP. I didn't want to like try so hard to figure out what everybody else was going through this time. And I was really nervous because honestly, sometimes I'm thinking, oh God, what if I don't give her the next song for the next soundtrack that she needs for her life, you know, this person
right.
that I meet, because there'll be so many of them and I almost feel responsible to create the soundtrack to people's lives. But Super Chris and the lyricist Opus is like the first time where I'm really writing the soundtrack to my life. And my life is like, almost like quirky. It's almost like I'm obsessed with art. I'm obsessed with creating. I'm obsessed with traveling, meeting people, and loving people, and spreading unity and all this stuff, but I don't talk about it because I don't think anybody will believe me. Yeah, like who really means that, you know?
Right.
So I'm almost embarrassed to talk about it because I don't think that it's believable. Okay, so the takedown process. Okay, I'm gonna tell you about mine today and then you can tell me what I should have did. So everybody, when they braid their hair around the edges, if they didn't go back to the salon 3 weeks after they got it done, it's gonna have that little bit of dirt build up by the scalp.
Mm-hmm.
So my method, this is gonna sound really gross, is to take some leave-in conditioner in my hands
mm-hmm.
and gently detangle it before I wash it.
so that I can pull apart the root nap that happens on those couple of little edge pieces. What would you say to do for the takedown process of braids?
What I would say to do, because you have that build up of dirt, oil, product, is I like to use a little bit of sea breeze.
Okay.
And you can put it in a spray bottle, mm-hmm. and you just mist it on that connection point where your braid is.
Okay.
And that actually helps to break down the oil, the dirt, the buildup, mm-hmm. so that it's easier to comb through so that you're not losing any hair.
Mm-hmm.
And then after you get the braid out and you're able to remove all of that buildup, then you can apply the leave-in conditioner mm-hmm. to keep the hair moisturized until you wash your hair.
Okay.
But the sea breeze will help to dissolve that little dirt.
Okay. That's a really gross secret. All braid girls go through it. Do not make believe you don't know what we're talking about.
Right. All the braid girls go through it.
Okay, so do you remember the first day we met?
I do.
I'm going to tell a story so everybody can hear it, but it's really embarrassing. So, I had gotten my hair braided, and the color was a smidgen different than my natural hair color. So I went to CVS, and I got hair dye to match the color of the extensions. I dyed my hair with braids in it and thought I washed it all out. 3 weeks later, I'm in Los Angeles in my new habitat, and I couldn't find anybody to tell me why my scalp was itching. So I went on Instagram and asked you guys, can you tell me who's the best braider in Hollywood? Brandy Norwood is like, you have to go see Dr. Kari. So I found your Instagram, I found your number, and when you saw me, my hair was an itchy mess. Can you tell girls why it is so important never to put dye in your hair when you have braids?
Well, I think the answer is obvious,
mm-hmm.
which is because you can't completely wash it out and shampoo it out. And so the residue of that hair color, which is a chemical, is sitting on the scalp and causing, I'm using my big scientific words, it's causing inflammation in a form of dermatitis. And so that's pretty much what you were experiencing.
Yeah.
Praise be to God.
Mm-hmm.
Your scalp is fine. We didn't have to scalp you.
Yeah.
And it was just a matter of being nice to your scalp. And you were able to soothe it with some peppermint and tea tree oil.
Yes.
Mixture.
Which, is it okay for me to mention that?
Yeah.
The Damn Salon is the name of this lady. She has this peppermint and tea tree oil concoction that really soothed my scalp. So Dr. Kari used the peppermint and the tea tree oil. You used like a shampoo, right?
We had a peppermint tea tree shampoo, mm-hmm. and then you had the oil from mm-hmm. that Damn Salon.
Yep.
And we just monitored your scalp.
Yeah.
The inflammation went down, it went away, it stopped flaking, and...
Did you use a special kind of hair for the next set of braids that I got, why it wasn't itchy, or was that synthetic?
It was synthetic.
Okay.
Your itchy scalp was purely from that color.
That ridiculous idea.
Sitting in your hair a little too long.
That is my most embarrassing hair story, if anybody ever wants to know. That was mortifying. In the back of my head, I was thinking, this is a celebrity hairstylist. Brandy's gonna find out that I'm an idiot. This is the end of my, being a hair girl. So,
yeah. No, it wasn't the end. It wasn't the end. Just a learning experience, and I'm pretty sure everyone out there can relate to trying to solve a problem themselves, mm-hmm. whether it was for ease, because it's just a quick fix, whether it was because of budget.
Well, I had a big show, and I...
Quick just, fix.
I needed to do it now, you know?
Right.
I could have just put a head wrap on instead and just fixed it later, but I didn't.
But it's okay.
It's okay. We're here now.
We have hair.
And we've got some hair on our
And it's head. One color.
And it's one color. God bless.
Okay, so favorite lyric, am I a superstar? No, I'm Super Chris.
Yeah, you know, the whole celebrity, star, famous thing, I've been trying to turn myself into that because I think it's what's expected. obviously I'm having like a self-actualization moment with this record, where I'm beginning to realize that it's okay to just be who I think I am and not what I think people think. Do you know?
Yeah.
But you get introduced on stage and they say, Motown recording artist, Grammy Award winning, and that's your first name. Your last name is Chrisette Michele.
Oh, interesting.
Do you know? And you try and remember that your actual name is Chris, because that's where your essence is. That's where your dream started.
Right.
You know, in elementary school, when you were holding the brush and singing, you know, Ella Fitzgerald lyrics, you're Chris. And when you're on the stage, your name is not Motown recording artist. Your name is not Grammy Award winning. Your name is Chris. And I wanted to let people know that I was okay with being the essence of the beginning of all of this, being the essence of how it all started, being a dreamer still, you know, being a hopeful romantic still, and being okay with that. So, am I a superstar? Who defines that?
Right.
But what I can define is to be the best me that I know how to be, and what that looks like. You know, and everybody is a super them. So I hope that this song makes everybody have their new anthem for themselves.
Oh yeah.
Because you could be super Dr. Kari.
Oh yes, I am.
Right?
Yes. You have started something for the people.
Yeah, so.
I am super Dr. Kari.
And I'm super Chris.
Yes.
And we're signing out. We had so much fun hanging out with you guys at Mahogany Salon today with Dr. Kari. She gave me the hookup, and she'll give you the hookup too, so don't forget to follow her on
Instagram at Dr. Kari Will, and on Twitter, Dr. Kari Williams.
Peace. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.